No research activity would be possible without laboratories, observatories, collections, libraries, databanks, and recently, computers. They all form a complex system of research infrastructures. Science relies on them. Infrastructures and research are inseparable. The accelerating globalization of science and technology urges the European Union to increase investment in research. The European Commission offers supplementary funding to stimulate the coordinated development of new installations and to ensure that researchers have wider, free of charge, transnational access to infrastructures in different member states. To support such activities, 1.7 billion euros was reserved in the capacities part of the 7th Framework Programme. How are these funds being utilized? Let's have a look at some examples.
You are here in the Gran Sasso Underground Laboratory, the largest underground laboratory of physics, particle and astroparticle physics. Why we need underground laboratories? Because there are particles, very fascinating and still mysterious particles, like neutrinos or dark matter particles, which need to be studied in an environment which is protected against sources of noise like cosmic rays. The neutrinos we detect are coming from the Sun, neutrinos from supernova explosion we hope to detect soon, and neutrinos coming from an artificial beam from CERN. Here it is possible to study this particle because the mountain works like an umbrella, repairing all the detectors from the rain of charged particles, like cosmic rays particles arriving from the sky, which are not the particles we want to study, but which will make a terrible noise in our detectors. We have 800 users of the laboratory coming from all over the world, and it is important that this research is supported in the framework program of the European Union, allowing free access to physicists, to young engineers, and also I think it is important for a coordination among all the laboratory in this field. So I think that this kind of infrastructure is important for the future of science, and I think in the next years we will hear news about that.
Share is a very large data set on the health, quality of life, economic and social living conditions of the 50 plus in Europe. It serves researchers and policymakers alike to meet the challenges of aging. Aging, as you all know, demographic change, is one of the biggest challenges of the 21st century. The combination of multidisciplinary longitudinality and at the same time cross-nationality has never been tried before. So that is unique and very innovative. Users love particularly the cross-nationality of shared data because it serves them as a kind of laboratory. You see different kinds of policies applied in different countries, and you can compare the reaction. So it's much more like natural science. SHARE spends a lot of effort on ensuring consistency of the data across the various countries we have. We ask exactly the same question. We are very careful about the language that we adapted to every country. We use the same procedures in sampling the people, but also in processing the data and performing the interviews. Cher is really grateful to the European Commission to have sponsored the making of the prototype of Cher. So they provided, the EU provided the essential input, the seed money for Cher. We are sure that also in the future the EU will be crucial to ascertain the cohesion of the project, the ex-ante harmonization.
Modern science cannot exist without information management and data analysis, which are of critical importance for further research development.
Driver is an electronic infrastructure. Its multinational nature is unique, harvesting documents from repositories from so many countries. And its emphasis on open access is also unique, bringing the results of European research to the world without any obstacles. The University of Athens is the coordinator of Driver, collaborating with institutions and repositories from many European countries, so funding from the European Commission was instrumental for Driver. Science always progresses by building on previous results. Driver brings such results in one place for easy access, so its services are critical for the advancement of science.
Driver 2 focuses on open access documents and has close to 1 million documents from several countries. If we want to browse for documents, we have immediate information about authors, descriptions and data, and can search across all repositories for any particular term.
The big challenge we face in biomedical research is to understand why some people remain healthy until high age, whereas others develop certain diseases. And if they're treated, some patients develop side reactions, whereas respond properly. This, however, requires having the opportunity to investigate samples from these patients, like blood or tissues, and also having access to information on the disease and the lifestyle. And so the infrastructure for biobanking and biomarker resources now provides this interface to the healthcare systems of various European member states and also access to populations of European countries. This infrastructure should now allow to integrate the resources that are built up in various member states and also develop the harmonization in order to allow us to integrate these samples and data so that we can now perform a new generation of research projects which were not possible so far. Europe has now a unique opportunity because there are six infrastructures in the life science field in its preparatory phase. And these infrastructures have many synergies, for instance, in the biobanking, but also in the bioinformatics. But moreover, they more or less support the whole value generating chain from basic research until application in patients. And so if we succeed in establishing these infrastructures, Europe will generate enormous momentum in the life science field. And basically, this will be the implementation of the concept of an European research area.
We are at the Institute of Plasma Physics and Laser Microfusion, where the world's largest plasma-focused generator is operating since 1997. This plasma generator is a basic element of the infrastructure we are offering to external users within the frame of European Framework Program Transnational Access. Plasma focus is a very intense source of various types of radiation, neutrons, hard and soft X-rays, fast ions. This radiation can be used in various applications. Dense magnetized plasma is a very interesting field of research. Apart from very powerful plasma generator, we are offering very modern, we can say, cutting-edge diagnostic systems like laser interferometry, ultra-fast optical cameras, systems of neutron probes for measurements of neutron characteristics. Europe does not have such a strong plasma generators like USA and Russia. So our plasma generator offers at least possibility to keep in touch with the leading centers.
Researchers need more and more specialized, sophisticated equipment to expand their knowledge and to build the fundamentals of new technologies, which in turn give way to the applications and products that change our lives. The equipment is, however, costly, and often no single member state can afford to build and maintain large installations. Common efforts are indispensable. As it says in the Green Paper on European Research Area, European-level infrastructure can provide a service to the whole European research community. Due to high building and operating costs, it also makes sense to share much of this infrastructure.